Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. This time we're going to present 5 anime recommendations from fall 2011. Before we start, don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. Check it out! Number 5 is Boku wa Tomodachi ga Sukunai. Boku wa Tomodachi ga Sukunai is an anime adaptation from light novel with the same name made by Buriki and Yomi Hirasaka. The first season of this anime aired from October 2011 to December 2011, and the second season aired from January 2013 to March 2013, with each season had a total 12 episodes. Boku wa Tomodachi ga Sukunai tells story about Kodaka Hasegawa, who finds out that he will be transferred to a new school. He is determined to make a positive impression, and maybe even some friends. However, Kodaka discovers he is out of luck when he immediately gets labeled as a violent delinquent due to his blonde hair and intimidating expressions. Although a month has passed, Kodaka is still alone thanks to his notorious reputation. However, his life begins to change when he finds fellow loner Yozora Mikazuki talking to her imaginary friend in an empty classroom. After sharing stories of their lonely high school life, Kodaka and Yozora decide to overcome the difficulties of making friends together by starting a neighbor's club. Created for people who don't have friends, daily activities involve learning social skills and how to fit in, which will hopefully allow them to make friends. Joined by the ever-loving Sena Kazuwaseki and other eccentric outcasts, Kodaka may finally have managed to find people he can call friends in this club filled with hilarious oddballs. Boku wa Tomodachi ga Sukunai presents a harem anime filled with elements of romance and comedy that are able to entertain and does not feel boring. This anime is able to provide a simple story, but because the story is interesting and fun, making this anime does not feel boring to watch in each episode. The element of romance that was delivered in this anime, though at first was not really visible, but as the story progressed, we will see some romantic moments between Kodaka as the main character, along with some female characters in this anime. The most interesting thing about this anime is the comedic element. We will be presented with a variety of strange and ridiculous behavior from the characters and funny jokes, even though sometimes this anime slips some dirty jokes that will be able to make us laugh out loud when watching it. The characters itself feel unique, seen from the different personality of each character. Even so, the interactions that occur between the characters are fun to watch, and the chemistry that exists between the characters feels quite good. The visuals presented look standard, both in terms of animation and background art. Even so, the attractive character designs and occasional displays of fan service will attract your attention, especially for male audience. Overall, this anime is a harem anime that is quite entertaining with a quite unique concept. If you like harem anime, then this anime is suitable for you to watch. Number 4 is Mirai Nikki. Mirai Nikki is an anime adaptation from manga with the same name made by Sakai Asuno. This anime aired from October 2011 to April 2012, with a total of 26 episodes. Mirai Nikki tells story about a lonely high school student, Yukiteru Amano, who spends his days writing a diary on his cell phone while conversing with his two seemingly imaginary friends, Deus Ex Machina, who is the god of time and space, and Murmur, the god's servant. Revealing himself to be an actual entity, Deus grants Yukiteru a random diary which shows highly descriptive entries based on the future and forces him into a bloody battle royale with 11 other holders of similarly powerful future diaries. With the last person standing designated as the new god of time and space, Yukiteru must find and kill the other 11 in order to survive. He reluctantly teams up with his obsessive stalker Yuno Gosai, who also possesses such a diary, and she takes it upon herself to ensure his safety. But there is more to the girl that meets the eye, as she might have other plans for her unrequited love. Mirai Nikki presents a survival battle royale themed anime full of mystery, intense action, and psychological games. In this anime, we will see how the main character Yukiteru Amano must engage in a bloody battle royale that forces him to be the last person to live among 11 other people, because if not, he will die. Whereas if he survives to the end, he will become a new god of space and time. Different from the battle royale anime in general, the battle royale participants in this anime are given various diaries that have different abilities, and this has a big influence on the ongoing battle royale. As mentioned before, this anime is full of interesting mysteries, such as the truth of the ongoing battle royale, the true background of the heroine character Yuno Gosai, and many more. Then, for the various action and battle scenes in this anime itself feel so intense, explicit, and full of psychological games. For the characters in this anime, it is very obvious that almost all of the characters have unique personalities and backgrounds. This makes the story told in this anime interesting to follow by each episode. The visuals presented by this anime are pretty good, both from the animation, the background art, and even the character design. Overall, if you're looking for an action anime with battle royale theme, then this anime is suitable for you to watch. Number 3 is Chihayafuru. Chihayafuru is an anime adaptation from manga with the same name made by Yuki Setsugu. The first season of this anime are from October 2011 to March 2012, with a total had 25 episodes. The second season aired from January 2013 to June 2013 with a total had 25 episodes. And the third season is currently airing from October 2019 until now. Chihayafuru tells story about Chihaya Ayase, a strong-willed and tomboyish girl who grows up under the shadow of her older sister. With no dreams of her own, she is contented with her share in life till she meets Arata Wataya. The quiet transfer student in her elementary class introduces her to competitive Karuta, a physically and mentally demanding card game inspired by the classic Japanese anthology of 100 Poets. Captivated by Arata's passion for the game and inspired by the possibility of becoming the best in Japan, Chihaya quickly falls in love with the world of Karuta. Along with the prodigy Arata and her haughty but hardworking friend Taichi Mashima, she joins the local Shiranami Society. The trio spends their idyllic childhood days playing together until circumstances split them up. Now in high school, Chihaya has grown into a Karuta freak. She aims to establish the municipal Mizuzawa High Competitive Karuta Club, setting her sights on the national championship at Omi Jingu. Reunited with the now indifferent Taichi, Chihaya's dream of establishing a Karuta team is only one step away from becoming true. She must bring together members with a passion for the game that matches her own. This anime is also one of the sports anime that is rarely found in other anime. This anime brings theme about Karuta game, which is a traditional card game containing poetry from Japan. In this anime, we are shown how Chihaya struggled in building the Karuta club in her school from scratch and her struggle in joining a national tournament. It can be seen even though the sports theme carried by this anime feels different, but the element like from zero to hero in this anime is no different from other sports anime. Coupled with the various conflicts and romance that are delivered, add to the excitement of the story itself. The development of each character feels very interesting to follow, and the interaction between the character is also interesting to watch. The visual presented seems simple and ordinary, but it feels right with the nuances of the story presented in this anime itself. Overall, if you're looking for a different sport anime, then this anime is suitable for you. Number 2 is Fate Zero. Fate Zero is an anime adaptation from light novel with the same name made by Gen Urobuchi and Takashi Takeuchi. The first season of this anime aired from October 2011 to December 2011 with a total had 13 episodes. And the second season aired from April 2012 to June 2012 with a total had 12 episodes. Fate Zero tells story about the omnipotent Holy Grail that grants and a wish was already triggered 3 wars in the past, each too cruel and fierce to live the victor. In spite of that, the wealthy Ansburn family is confident that the 4th Holy Grail war will be different, namely with the vessel of the Holy Grail now in their grasp. Solely for this reason, the much-hated Magus killer Kiritsugu Emiya is hurt by the Ansburns with marriage to the only daughter Iris Field as binding contract. Kiritsugu now stands at the center of a cutthroat game of survival, facing off against 6 other participants, each armed with an ancient familiar and fueled by unique desires and ideals. Accompanied by his own familiar, Saber, the notorious mercenary soon finds his greatest opponent in Kirai Kotomine, a priest who seeks salvation from the emptiness within himself in pursuit of Kiritsugu. Fate Zero presents an action anime mixed with magic and fancy elements that takes the setting in the modern day. This anime itself is quite unique because it displays several servant characters that are originally from characters in the real world. For the story in this anime itself can be delivered with strong narrative coupled with a variety of interesting conflicts and drama about the fight or the Holy Grail itself. The characters in this anime itself, both master and servant characters, have unique personalities and different backgrounds. The background story of each character is also able to be packaged neatly and attractively so that we know the motivation and purpose of each character in this anime. What story that's more interesting, solid, clear, mature than the previous series, namely Fates Day Night, is the strength for this anime. The visuals presented look very good, seen from a variety of action and battle scenes that are displayed and can be animated smoothly and neatly. And for the design of the characters are also able to be drawn attractively while still following the original novel illustration style. Overall, if you are looking for action anime mixed with magic and fantasy elements that has interesting and unique stories, then this anime is suitable for you to watch. Number 1 is Hunter x Hunter. Hunter x Hunter is an anime adaptation from manga with the same name made by Yoshihiro Togashi. This anime itself is a remake of Hunter x Hunter anime that aired from 1999 to 2001. This new Hunter x Hunter aired from October 2011 to September 2014, with a total had 148 episodes. Hunter x Hunter takes place in a world where hunters exist to perform all manner of dangerous tasks like capturing criminals and bravely searching for lost treasures in uncharted territories. 12-year-old Gonfrix is determined to become the best hunter possible in hopes of finding his father, who was a hunter himself and had long ago abandoned his young son. However, Gonson realizes the path to achieving his goals is far more challenging than he could have ever imagined. Along the way to becoming an official hunter, Gon befriends the lively doctor in training Leo Ryu, vengeful Kurapika, and rebellious ex-assassin Killua. To attend their own goals and desires, together the four of them take the Hunter exam, notorious for its low success rate and high probability of death. Throughout their journey, Gon and his friends embark on an adventure that puts them through many hardships and struggles. They will meet a plethora of monsters, creatures, and characters, all while learning what being a hunter truly means. This anime provides an interesting and entertaining adventure and friendship story. The story in this anime is also very well paced that can easily keep its viewer engaged with all the episodes. Each character in this anime has their own goals and motivations that make the story more interesting to follow. Interaction between characters such as Gon, Killua, Leo Ryu, and Kurapika also feel entertaining. The visuals presented are really well met, the battle animation presented also feels so fluent in each episode. Overall, this anime is one of the best action anime that is a pity if you miss it. Well guys, it's 5 anime recommendations from fall 2011 that we can present this time. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching and see you next time!